What's up, guys? It's Friday, and so you know what time it is. It's time for What the Fitness. But first, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment for the algorithm. And this week, we have back on one of our favorites, if not our favorite, good old Gary Brecka. Now, Gary has given us some absolute gems over the past couple of years, including you start to liquefy lean muscle in 3 minutes and all sorts of other nonsense. But for some reason, people still think this guy knows what he's talking about. It's been good, easy content for me, and it's been entertaining. And for that, we thank you. Shout out to Tosh.0. So this week, Gary was on the Sean Ryan show, which sucks for me because I actually like Sean and a lot of the stuff that he puts out. But anytime Gary puts out information on a podcast, he turns it into a hot, steaming pile of fecal matter. So maybe this one will be different, but I kind of doubt it. Let's see what he has to say about cancer and seed oils.
We can create an environment that's very hospitable for cancer. We can create an environment that's very inhospitable to cancer. So let's talk about a biome that is inhospitable to cancer. It's not really inviting.
He learned that word yesterday.
So we can talk about removing the unnecessary assault on our cellular biology. So things like pesticides, herbicides, glyphosates, insecticides.
Just unnecessarily insert cellular.
So eating whole foods in their natural format, avoiding things like seed oils. And if you still don't believe the research on seed oils, Paul Saladino just did a great short documentary on it.
Oh, the research on seed oils.
We take these canola plants or rapeseed plants, we put them in a commercial press, and the oil comes out very gummy. So we degum it with something called hexane, which is a neurotoxin. Then we take that neurotoxic degummed oil and we heat it to 405 degrees and we turn it rancid. Okay, so now you have a putrefied rancid oil. So then we have to deodorize it. So we deodorize it with sodium hydroxide, which is a known carcinogen. And then we, in some cases, we'll even bleach it, then bottle it, then put it on the shelf.
No.
So it's sometimes it's not even the food. It's the distance from the food to the table. So if you're listening to this, I would make today the day you get seed oils completely out of your diet. It's very hard to do. Sunflower, safflower, canola, rapeseed.
Yeah. People are getting cancer and getting sick, not because they smoke, they drink way too much alcohol, they're stressed out of their minds, partly from content like this. They eat on average over 3,500 calories a day, yet that's actual data. They do less than 20 minutes of physical activity per day. No. It's safflower oil and sunflower oil and rapeseed oil. That's it. Yeah, that's it. So first off, he just made most of that stuff up. But I will point out one thing he said that I would agree with, that eating whole foods in their natural form is usually best. I think that that is good advice in general. And if you eat whole fruits, vegetables, lean meats, that is a great place to start in any diet, minimally processed whole foods. Not because processing does some evil thing to food that makes it carcinogenic, but because processing causes it to energy densify, makes it very calorie dense, not very satiating, and people eat way too much. And we know obesity is a huge risk factor for cardiovascular disease, cancer, and all-cause mortality. Now, then he goes to, oh my God, they use hexane in the processing. They use sodium hydroxide. Sounds very, very scary. And this is how I know that this person has never taken basic organic chemistry class. Because if I went through how things are made that the vast majority of us use, they're made with toxic chemicals all the time. What matters is, are those chemicals present in the end product? And the answer is no. Hexane, sodium hydroxide, bleach, those can all be filtered out through various methodologies of distillation and separation. This is very, very basic organic chemistry synthesis. I did this kind of stuff when I was like 20 or 21 years old. It is really not that difficult if you've had basic organic chemistry, which apparently Gary has not, but he's a human biologist, whatever that means. Let's take all that aside. If these things were present, or if things were present, or if seed oils in general were carcinogenic, then we should pick up on that in the research literature. And seed oils are mostly polyunsaturated fats, specifically omega-6s. And Gary says they increase inflammation, they're going to give you cancer. You know, if only we had human randomized control trials looking at inflammation and human studies looking at the incidence of cancer and these sorts of fats. We actually do. He can say whatever he wants about the processing. What matters is, do they actually cause the thing he's saying they cause? Survey says no. In fact, he's talking about cooking with saturated fat, that saturated fat is better. Then why, oh why, in this meta-analysis looking at cancer mortality, does saturated fat increase the relative risk of dying from cancer by 10%? Oh, and also, polyunsaturated fats decrease the risk of cancer mortality by 6%. It wasn't quite significant, literally less than a 10,000th of a point off of being significant. So it's essentially the same thing. Not only do the polyunsaturated fats appear to decrease cancer mortality, they also possibly decrease all-cause mortality and cardiovascular disease mortality. Notice how they are to the protective side of the line, and saturated fats are the only fats that are to the risk side of this line. So again, I submit, if what he's saying is true, why do we not see it show up in the literature? And as for inflammation, if we look at the literature on polyunsaturated fats and even omega-6 fats, we see either neutral or positive effects on inflammation relative to saturated fat when exchanged one for one with saturated fat. And we see improvements in insulin sensitivity and liver fat and metabolic health. So again, he can say whatever he wants. He can do a bunch of hand waving about how things are made and these things are processed. Oh, by the way, processed, not in whole food form. Where's the stick of butter tree, by the way, Gary? Where can I go out in nature and like pick ghee butter off of? Oh wait, it's processed too, Gary. So if you want to invoke a certain type of logic, you also have to be okay with that logic being applied symmetrically. People like Gary don't like that. They only like to apply logic when it fits their particular bias, and then they disregard it when it doesn't fit their bias. And him saying, well, the people, if you don't believe the research by now, and then usually if you talked about research, like if I talk about research, I actually like show you the f***ing research. He invokes a Paul Saladino video. If I go to PubMed and I type in Paul Saladino, I will get absolutely no results because Paul Saladino is not a researcher. That is not research. A YouTube video is not research. If Gary has studies that I am not aware of, I am happy for him to submit them. And I'd like to remind everyone that Gary has backed out of not one but two debates with me after originally agreeing to do so. I would still be happy to have that conversation. I would be happy to discuss this topic as well as many others if he wasn't running faster than Usain Bolt. So again, he doesn't cite studies, but I'm sure that Gary is probably very busy dealing with his legal issues at the moment. If he ever wants to take a stop off of saying random on podcasts that's not true and wants to actually have a conversation with somebody who actually really knows what they're talking about, then I'll be here. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed the video and I will catch you next week.